Hello, it is Stop Motion Movie 123 here, I'm just, like, a creator commentary for my own Stop Motion Sonic the Hedgehog series. I just want to preface this by saying, no, I am not done with the series. I am going to make episode 12, I just haven't been able to get around to working on it, as I've been very busy with school and many other things. So we're starting off with, episode 1, the launch of the Death Egg, I believe that's what it's called, I remember, honestly. This intro is... This is technically the first thing of Stop Motion I made, and it looks so rough. Like, the animation is just so not fluid and, like, smooth. I mean, it's a product of its time, and again, like I was saying, this is the very first Stop Motion I have ever made. At least the very first serious kind of Stop Motion I ever made. The funny thing is, the more I watch these older episodes, the more I can actually see my own hand, like, and stuff. I find it funny how I put the, like, featuring, and then, so at the end of the, like, introducing each character, it says, right here, ciao. It says, and many more, even though that's literally all the characters in the series. I mean, I did introduce some new ones, like, Chao. But Chao doesn't actually really appear in the series, except for, like, part of episode 4, and then Chip does appear in episode 5, but he's not really a mainline character. I don't know if this is a normal thing, but I did not use, like, I used voice lines from the games. It just feels very primitive, in my opinion. Like, it doesn't work as well as I thought it did when I was first making it. I was actually originally going to, voice the characters, and I did actually record voice lines for it, and I do actually have a copy of this episode with my own voice lines, but, I mean, as you can imagine, that... It's not good, so I'll spare you for now. Mainly because I actually don't know how to get the thing, because I don't actually have the audio files anymore, but... It was bad. It wasn't actually, until episode 6. Technically episode 3. So I used this, like, weird gray Lego thingy. Ooh, that explode! No, that destruction sequence, that's not too bad, actually. But I use this, like, gray Lego thing to... I guess that's to emulate the, like, little, like, gray flash that happens when you hit, his, machine in the, like, classic Sonic games. I'm assuming that's what that is, and I even used a sound effect from it, so... That's what I would assume. That voice line of Knuckles saying, "Yeah, you right," that's not even from a Sonic game. I don't even actually remember where that's from. So when he enlists the help for, like, Shadow, it's supposed to be Shadow and Silver. But when I'm actually making the episode, I didn't have the Silver figure at the time, and I wasn't really using the Silver Funko Pop because it's way too big for the Jack-specific figures, which I did use the Silver Funko Pop, but now I do actually have a Silver figure, so it's all good. But anyways... I had this idea of, like, he somehow time-traveled to, like, the Super Mario dimension or something. And he just, like, he got hit by the, like, the size-up mushroom or the power-up thing. I don't know what you call it, but you know how in, like, World 1-1 in the first Mario, if there's the one block that gives you the mushroom that makes Mario, like, Big Mario. That's basically what I was going for there. This is also... a continuity error that happens in the series, because Classic Sonic is actually just kind of walking by, but then in episode 2, which here it is right now, he like goes through a portal. So this intro, I had to painstakingly copy and paste each frame, but for the frames with sound, I didn't know how to put the sound in there other than just copy and pasting the frame, so it looks so bad. Like, you can see it moving on some of the still frames. Like, It's especially easy on the, like, it's especially easy to notice on the Eggman portion. I mainly wanted to use a different song for this, being City Escape. I'm not really sure why, but, yeah. I just thought it would be an interesting addition, but I don't know. I love how there's no hand motion. Oh, right there, you can see it, like, twitching, kind of. But anyways, like, I love how there's no hand motion, but it literally breaks the pencil in half. That's pretty funny. Oh, right here on the Eggman part. See, right there. I find it funny how I put Chow in the intro for these, but Chow is not even really in the series at all, except being used as a weapon. I think maybe I should make a Chow episode. Maybe that will be episode 13, like, based off the Chow Garden from SA2. I find it funny how I literally called for Shadow, but he says, Shadow, what are you doing? Like, Sonic, that was your, you deliberately called for Shadow, but whatever. Same thing with episode 1, I was going to voice Classic Sonic, but I couldn't get it to sound good. I did voice him in, episode 3, mainly because, well, there's no real Classic Sonic voice lines. In Generations and all the other games that he appears in, he does not speak. In Sonic CD, he has, like, 2 lines. And I wasn't about to watch the OVA again. I love Sonic the Hedgehog, the OVA. It is the best Sonic movie. Oh my gosh, I love that sound effect. But anyways, like, I don't want to just go through that to find Classic Sonic voice lines. I love how I didn't even attempt to extract the voice line, so it's just Sonic talking. So you get the background music from the cutscene I used and stuff.
You're too slow. Come on, step it up.
Wow. Okay, now we are in episode 3. Honestly, so this is one of my classmates' favorite episode out of all the ones I've done. But you'll notice a theme with these early episodes. The intro is way too long. Like, I don't actually remember exactly how long. It takes up, like, almost 2 minutes. Maybe even longer than 2 minutes. I don't know. But, yeah, it takes up really long for the episode. And it's just, ugh. That being said, I do like the intros, but they're just way too long. Like, they're way too long for their own good. Like, is all this stuff really necessary? Like, it's not, it's just... Okay, I legit bought grapes just so I could have him, like, being... I do love the grapes. The grapes are delicious. I love it. It's just amazing. Oh, you can see my hand on the, like, the bullet muzzle flash. Yeah, like, all of this stuff. It's funny, I don't know how to make sets. I mean, there's the Sonic House set, but that's just made out of, like, a cardboard box, and I just stuck some things on there and called it a day. Oh, that's actually where I implemented the silver, mushroom thing from Mario. Although he just kicks it, and it just breaks on the wall. It's like a friggin' How to Basic video. And many more. Even though there's no more characters. Stop the Death Egg, alright.
Let's blast through with Sonic speed!
So now they're, like, super. I didn't have any, like, super tails or super knuckles or whatever. I mean, technically, they don't really, aren't really a thing except for Sonic 3 and Knuckles and I think in Sonic Mini, but I don't actually know. I don't really like that. It doesn't really sound good. I found it funny how Tails never even been to the Death Egg before. At least that's not canonically in the series. He somehow knows how to get into the Death Egg, which is kind of funny. I bit crushed his voice to emulate the kind of like the voice on like an old game console kind of sound. It works, but it does sound really bad, which is why I stopped using it, and I only used it for this episode. Like, it's not bad, but like, again, it's just I hate it. This was all done in my like storage room and stuff, and it was actually pretty fun doing this. Man. Yeah, but just, yeah. I don't like how I was using lines from the video games. I more prefer actually voice acting, especially since you're now actually free to kind of put what you want. So, in this scene, right here where he scans the QR code, I showed this to one of my cousins. And he was like, but he doesn't actually scan the QR code, right? And I was like, he does. I mean, not actually, but... In my series, Shadow, it's like, this is continuing his SA2 arc, I guess. His character in SA2. Where he actually does regain his memories and stuff of Maria and all the other stuff. But he just has to remember... All that stuff again. All the grapes. They're secretly an explosion. Alright.
Oh no.
Anyways, I love how when I wanted to insert like clips from like movies or like TV shows or whatever, I didn't actually just put it in there. I legit just took frames of parts of the scene. Which it doesn't look good again. So episode 4, Head-to-Head, starts off with a recap, which is actually something I think I only did in this episode.
Well, if only you knew that there was dynamite in those grapes.
Right there, you can see I didn't use the bit crush there for Classic Sonic voice.
Hey!
Okay, this fight scene with Super Sonic and Metal Sonic is actually really cool in my opinion. Like... Again, the stop motion, it looks clunky, and it's not, again, it's not smooth, it doesn't look perfect, but, man, like, it does look, it's really good. Especially for my typical stop motion quality, I guess, that's what you would call it. This is probably my favorite episode, just for this choreography. And I especially love how he gets thrown through the wall, and I made a hole in the box. Like, it's just so awesome. Oh. Ooh, yeah, man. Okay. So this is this right here is a reference to Sonic Unleashed, the opening, to the point where I even actually use sound effects from Sonic Unleashed. I love how I use an actual, like, emerald, like the Chaos Emerald, but I just use, like, guitar picks and, like, rocks for the rest of them. I mean, it's not easy to tell, but, yeah. But this is the only episode where there are Chaos Emeralds, later in the series, like, it's, alright, this shot looks pretty cool, not gonna lie, with the, like, interspersing of the shots, but anyways,
no way, I can't believe this.
Yeah, I even used sound effects from it. But anyways, in the later episodes, they were super emeralds. Okay, okay, maybe. It just falls out of space. And this scene right here, I was gonna have Metal Sonic say, "Can I join your side?" But I didn't want him to, like, do that. I just wanted Sonic to take him, and that is the basis for the plot of episode 6, where Tails recodes him, and Metal Sonic is now actually a part of the team, which, honestly, I really like, because I like Metal Sonic. I don't really particularly like him being an antagonist. Are there, the chow is used for literally a fraction of a second. So this is where I used credits for, like, where I got the voice lines from. But that's pretty much all there is to these credits. It's not really that. Oh my goodness. I keep forgetting what I'm going to say, honestly. Alright, episode 5, Want Some Chocolate. This is where we start off with the brand new intro, which I would use until the end of season 1, I guess. Basically, till episode 10. Well, now I have a new intro, which honestly I like more, but this intro is nice, it's short, and, you know, it's not too bad. Like, it's not just a bunch of action shots of characters, and then they say... Then they introduce themselves. I do think it could be a little bit shorter. It clocks in at about a minute. I think it could have been definitely shorter, but it doesn't matter to me that much. So that's when I started using the censor for swear words, where a character just interrupts a character. Okay, technically the chow is used in the series. It's just not really a notable character. Okay. Oh my goodness. So that's supposed to be like a PlayStation 5 or something. I think that's just because I had gotten a PlayStation 5 there.
Hey,
Sonic. Right here, you can actually see how the figure, the silver Funko Pop, it's way bigger than the Jack specific line, which I use for all the characters. Or I think the Amy one isn't a Jack-specific one, but I could be wrong on that.
He must have run off.
I love how I just splats. that's one of the few moments I can actually get a good laugh at in the series. You get the montage. I think this song, Fight Fire with Fire by Metallica, actually works really well. The combat in this, I don't think is as unique as in episode 4, but I think it's definitely better well made.
It's no use.
I definitely use "it's no use" way too often. That's one thing I will admit this? With this series, is I definitely overuse "it's no use."
Time for a knuckle sandwich.
Man, the voice lines I picked, they're good, but sometimes they're kind of, they don't make much sense. Now the stop motion smoothness is a lot better in this episode, but still not perfect. You know, actually, I was wrong. The combat is way more unique than episode 4. I found it funny how the truck goes over top of him, but that would literally just squish Shadow, and that would probably kill him.
Shadow, what are you doing?
Don't touch it.
I love the "don't touch it." I gotta use "don't touch it" again in this series.
No!
I actually kind of sound a lot like it. "Don't touch it." And now they all get blown off. I gotta use the "don't touch it" in like a later episode now. Especially with my voice acting, because I can actually sound a lot like it, surprisingly. Uh, I love how most of the time I couldn't figure out how to do like an impact, so I just put a white flash. It looks pretty good though. Oh, there's Chip. I wish there was a figure of Chip so I could actually bring him back, because I don't like the drawing I made of Chip. Like, I mean, I can draw fine, it's just, like, not when doing characters. So this is before I had a specific effect catered for Shadow when he was removing his inhibitor rings, which is, like, this red aura, which I now have, because I can actually... This is before I used Kindmaster to actually do more than just put the intro and the episode together. I love how he just steps on him. I love how it's a real hammer, too. I mean, it's just me working with what I had. The old Spindash just looks so weird that I used for the series.
Just give me a chance! This is new. Showing remorse,
I think this dialogue from Unleashed really works very well. Especially with the music. It actually looks pretty cool how it, like, the frames get all, like, blurry and stuff. And then it just fades to black. That's pretty cool. Okay, episode 6. This is a... extremely great improvement from the previous episodes. Although, I feel like it's basically just episode 5, but just packaged differently, because you both got Sonic oversleeping, Tails waking him up, having to show him something, and then there's a big fight encounter with Eggman as a surprise at the end. It's basically just episode 5, just repackaged. It's packaged differently, wrapped differently, I don't know what you want to call it, but... Okay, once again, Big appears in the intro, but just like Chow, it's not really used in the series at all. I mean, Chow is used in the series, but not really for anything notable. I do like how the song goes from the full song to just, like, the vocals only. I think it's a nice thing, I think. Okay, so this is where we started voice acting the characters.
5 more minutes, please.
Sonic, wake up. We have no time. I want to show you.
So the voice of Tails, that was done by one of my cousins. I'm not going to tell you her name. I'm not going to show who she is. But honestly, I think her voice actually is really good for Tails. And we do actually contact each other. So I think she can actually be brought on for future episodes.
Wow, he's too fast for his own good.
That line, "and I for one will have none of it," you do not want to know how many takes that took to get her to actually say it. So here we can find all the, like, audios and, like, outtakes of stuff.
I recoded Metal Sonic, so he's on our side now.
And, like, all this stuff we recorded.
5 more.
Sonic, wake up. Yeah, just follow me to my lab. I'll show
you. Okay, well, like, you get the gist of it.
And I, for one, will not have none of it.
So I think that chopped up was the final line, but I could be wrong. Okay, here's the actual final line.
And I, for one, will have none of it.
So I think this is me saying it.
And I, for one, will have none of it.
Yeah, that's me saying it. You can tell because it sounds terrible. Okay, this one is like... if her saying it if she was drunk.
And I, for one, will... have none of it.
Okay, good.
I love how I say okay, good, even though that was, like, not... I mean, not to throw any shade at her, but, I mean, she's a young kid, but, you know. And that's only just a fraction of how many takes. That's all of the takes that I could find. But, like, she was constantly accidentally saying, "and I, for one, will never have it." When it was actually, and I for one, it took us at least like 2 hours just to get that one line, which sounds insane, but at least you got it. So, yay.
So, is this your
so I would consider this the very first instance of actually using a set. I love how they just have to like, duck down to go through the door because it's not tall enough for the Jack specific figures. Shadow, I love how you can't. You and also, I like how they.
Out the door. What's happening?
Gosh, that shadow line is just distorted as all heck. It's kind of crazy.
See now.
The cat. Oh my goodness.
Less destructive way. Oh, okay. Sorry.
Oh, and also tails. Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
This is just.
Whoa! Can you make grapes? Wow!
Oh.
Okay. Tails, you know that's a missed opportunity.
Wow. So yeah, here's the surprise attack from Eggman slash Robotnik. I don't. Otherwise, like I don't care. Another sensor of just interrupting the character. I love how, again, it's just distorted. Because I was talking to like the phone microphone. No, I'm sure he doesn't want to play tag. Oh, he just goes to. I think that's just me trying to replicate episode 4, but I don't know. I love how it's just a Minecraft TNT drawing. Oh my goodness. Yeah, this combat, it's actually pretty good. And here you can see where I switched places. That was at her house, where I recorded all the voice lines for Tails. And then this is at my own house, which is where I'm recording this audio right now. So I don't have like Badnik figures, so I just use Monster Jam trucks. Honestly, it actually works kind of nice.
I've got a trick on my sleeve. Are you kidding me?
I don't get why they start like screaming. Like that's just a weird creative decision I made, but and whatever. Because I guess it's not.
Bad. And how would you do that? I mean, I've literally proved you wrong. Okay, think. Okay,
this walking friends, animation is not too bad.
Now what can I do?
I love how Eggman's just eating actual popcorn while Sonic is struggling to think.
I'm getting bored. There might be one thing I could do. And what is that? You know what it is. No, I don't. Oh, come on. We've done this so many times. I don't think it would be impossible for you to guess it.
That don't live. That delivery on the bad. But like then this is when I started voice acting the characters. Like I definitely get better as the episodes continue. Oh, you can see Sonic is just propped up against the landmine thing, which is actually my remote camera that I use, but I don't typically use it.
Does that really matter?
Is that a Top Gun reference?
I'm just gonna get out of your hair. Well, too
late. I love how Shadow just knows that it's a Top Gun reference.
It's no use.
Another random decision I made. The Chow does appear, but not really for any notable thing other than to just be used as a weapon. Because it's literally, he's just thrown so many times at the villain. Oh, I literally had his arms go back behind him like he runs in the Clash of Sonic games. It's pretty funny. Oh, you can see by directed by input title because I was using VN Video Editor and that it puts it at the end of the videos and I didn't remember to delete it. So now we are at episode 7, Out the Window. This episode is probably my favorite out of all the ones I've done so far, 1 through 11. I think it's because like it's just pretty. It's unique. I don't know how to explain it, to be honest.
Now begins the glorious era of the Empire.
In this episode, I reused some lines from episode 6, and I did a awful Tails impression. It's really bad. I love how the child just explodes. Out the window.
Okay, I gotta stop playing around and be be able to capture Sonic. Maybe if I make the scene, they can capture Tails.
I hate my old impression of Eggman.
Now time to put my plans
in. Robotnik, whatever you want to call him. It sounded like this, and I mean, it's passable for him, but it's not good. But now, I sound like this when I'm doing his voice, and it sounds a lot better. But I actually think I'm actually going to have my friend, who voiced him in episode 11, do it. This is what, he does a really good Eggman, I'm not going to lie. What about Tails is super small and he's playing a PS5 game that with a controller like five times his size? That's pretty funny. That's Sonic Colors Ultimate.
What?
I love how Tails' house is the exact same set as Sonic's house.
You something.
Because I didn't bother to build one because I just...
Right there.
See, you can see the terrible Sonic drawing. And you can see the TV. Drawing on there too.
His machines always freaking suck. And we always get him, so it's probably no problem.
Gosh.
Even if it is.
My Tails impression is just so bad.
Here are the directions. Okay. So. Let me see. This is a Chaos Emerald generator. Please step in to get.
So for these directions, I was originally gonna have. It, like, Eggman was in disguise as, like, a delivery person saying, like, hey, you must be Sonic the Hedgehog, and then, like, you know, delivering the thing. But I wanted it to just have instructions. I wanted it to be so outlandishly stupid, and then for him to just believe that it was legit. Which, Sonic is a very smart character, at least in this series. So, the fact that he thinks this is legit is just... That's gotta be an oversight by me. Like, again, like, I don't know what was going through my mind when I was making these, honestly.
I feel like if this machine malfunctioned or something, you might be the best
one. Oh.
Geeky.
Okay.
Like, my Tails voice, it's so bad. It's just... Oh.
Wait, what?
I found it funny how, like, so he says, you might be the best to fix it, because, well, how would Tails even fix it? He's on the inside, and all the modifications, or, like, all the fixes and stuff that he would have to do would have to be on the outside. So I was originally gonna have a better idea for, like, this prison cell looking set. I had a better idea for how it was gonna go. I found it funny how he's just counting off the days. Like he's writing like a friggin' a journal or something. He's doing the idle animation from Classic Sonic.
I'm about to give up. Is he ever coming back? No.
Oh.
There's just no way.
This montage with the Unforgiven 3 is pretty cool.
I bet Sonic's like, oh, I miss my
friend. I love how he's just like. I bet Sonic is like, oh, I miss my friend! And then he's just doing like a mocking dance. That part where it turns to gray is pretty good. The door animation for these isn't very good, but I can't fault myself for it because, well, I mean, I didn't really know how to make it. This montage is pretty good, honestly. This is probably my favorite part of the episode. Oh, the camera panning. It looks, it's like, it's really good, but it looks so bad. He just smacks the paper phone out of his hand. It's supposed to be a phone, but you can't, I guess you can't really tell. Especially with no dialogue. Here where he puts in the, oh, that's a wine glass. That's supposed to be a mirror, I guess. So when he puts in the Chaos Emerald in the, like, the chest part of Metal Sonic, actually, I think I want to make that, like, some sort of plot or something that might power Metal Sonic up. Also, that's not the same Metal Sonic that Tails recodes in episode 6. Like, basically, I'll give you a sneak peek. Eggman just builds many different Metal Sonics. I only have one Metal Sonic figure, but... I think I could figure out a way to mitigate that. He just kicks him. He just abuses him. Like, yeah.
I think it's pretty nice.
The montage, not Tails getting abused. Tails is my favorite Sonic character, by the way. I think Metal Sonic is actually my favorite Sonic character, though.
It's kind of funny how they're like, they're supposed to be talking, but you don't even know what they're saying to him. I think, like, how this is going to go, you just have to, you come up with what they're saying on your own, you know? There's, like, some fan input, because I don't script these stop motions. How I make, I just kind of come up with a basic idea of what I want to do. And I don't even script it at all or anything, which I think I should probably script it so I can make the stop motion better. But I just do the stop motion and then I just kind of make up the story as I go along. Which I think that's kind of obvious, but then again, I don't know. When I show this episode to my friend Atticus, his channel is called Flabbergast, go check it out. I'll link it in the description. When he goes supersonic to get Tails, like, he was like, why did Sonic not do this years ago? And I was like, that's not the timeline of this episode. This is days, not years.
No!
This is something funny I wanted to point out.
We'll gotta think of a plan.
Said that right.
Too late now, I guess.
I love how Eggman, he just has the most, like, accented voice, and he's like, too late now, I guess. Too late now, I guess. I'm a country singer now. Too late now, I guess. it's pretty funny, in my opinion. I love how I put credits of, like, who voices the characters, but almost all of them are done by me. And I don't like the handwritten credits. It doesn't look good. All right, episode 8, Recover. This is where I started using KineMaster to edit the videos. I mean, you can see the both KineMaster watermarks. Speaking of the KineMaster watermark, I hate how they made it so big now. Like, it used to be small and, you know, not such a big deal, but now it's practically just right in your face. Like, yeah, I get that you want us to know that it was made with it, but, like, you don't have to. And I don't want to pay for the premium version. It's, like, $40 for, like, a year-long plan, and that's just ridiculous. I mean,
if you go frame by frame on Eggman's typing, you can see he's typing, can you eat a cat?
If you, like, play the section where, like, it flashes to all the characters right here, Eggman is dabbing. He's dabbing. Now, this is the only episode where every scene takes place outside. And I would do another outside episode, but I can't really. Because, well, it's winter as of right now. And a big blizzard just hit. So now, yeah. I think the outside looks pretty good, honestly. Maybe I could use this for, like, a green force thing. Oh, I'm surprised I didn't have to, like, wash down the shadow character after, like, been playing it around in the dirt so much.
Why? I'm trying to give you a hand. I don't need your help. Now get out of my way!
This stuff is pretty good.
I'm going.
Like, this episode is really good in my opinion. Especially this shot.
There's simply no reason.
Like, this is all really good. This is right up there with episode 7 as one of my favorite episodes. He's just thinking to himself, you know. Then it gets blown up because you're not allowed to swear. You're not allowed to swear, Shadow. This is a family-friendly series. I want kids to be able to watch it and their parents not be mad at me. I love the fourth wall breaks. I don't think fourth wall breaking is, like, really. Like, it doesn't work in this series, but it's nice. So I don't even have an effect for Shadow moving his inhibitor rings. You can see the rings on his hand because I didn't, like, there's no way you can actually remove them. And I don't want to destroy my Shadow figure because I spent monies. So, I don't know.
Where am I? Huh? How did these get back on?
Doesn't the rings back on.
I'm gonna go kick some
I don't really like
Why does everyone keep cutting me off?
Shadow, if you're gonna fight someone, then you should probably recover first, or else you might die.
Shadow, the reason people keep cutting you off is because you're not allowed to swear on here.
Maybe.
But anyways, yeah. I don't like how people call Shadow an edgelord, because he's not an edgelord, he's just portrayed as one by the fanbase because of the Shadow the Hedgehog game. If you want a good, reason as to why this is, you should go check out, this video called, I think it's called Why Shadow is the Best Sonic Character. I could be wrong on what it's called, but I don't remember who uploaded the video, but it's called, like, Why Shadow is the Best Sonic Character or something.
You can call me Knuckles. I'm Shadow the Hedgehog.
So, episode 9, Shaken Up. This one, I really didn't know what to do for this, because I wanted a climax for episode 10, which I didn't really get, and so I just needed an episode to go before it. And originally, so at the end of episode, at the end of this episode, where he's like, you know, he's there, like, the coast is clear, it's supposed to take place, episode 10 was supposed to take place right after, episode 9, or this episode right here that we're watching right now, but, it's really, like, I just couldn't make it work because I had to edit the Fleetway Supersonic head onto the Supersonic, which works in this episode, but it doesn't look that good.
I actually know
how to use keyframes now, so the fact that's okay, yeah. I don't really like my voice acting for this part. It's not very good in my opinion, honestly. But anyways, yeah, I know how to add keyframes, so I think I can actually make the Fleetway Supersonic thing work. And I made the episode, like, a long time ago, so...
I legit do not know what you're saying.
You're like, I made it before...
Who is this?
I made it right after this episode, and so it's probably not gonna look as good as, you know, like, what episode 11 and 12 are gonna be, so I'm probably... It's gonna be the final episode of the series, and it's going to,
I want to know who you are.
I'm gonna redo it so it's way better, you know, and, yeah. But when I do end this Stop Motion Sonic Motion, I'm not gonna just stop uploading Stop Motion Sonic Motion content. I'm just not gonna do episodes of the series anymore.
Cosplay of me in my super form. What is
it's like
this?
A bad cosplay of me in my super form. Yeah.
Seen what this is.
That line is kind of stupid, not gonna lie. See, right here, it doesn't look that good, especially since it's a completely different shade of yellow than the actual supersonic figure, but whatever.
No! Well, this is too bad.
Yeah, it doesn't look good because I wasn't using keyframes, and I didn't even know how to use keyframes at the time. But I do now, so I think we can mitigate that for the actual episode. Then here we have Tails doll. The little ruby gem thing was actually because one of my other cousins, wanted me to, like, make his Tails plush. He doesn't have the Tails plush anymore, but he wanted me to make it, like, Tails doll.
What's happening?
So I just made this little ruby gem thing so that we could tape onto it, but...
I don't get killed.
I never used it, so I used it here. Alright, episode 10. Last episode of... the season... So, I was pretty bummed out that I wasn't able to do the Fleetway Supersonic thing, but now I think I know that how I can do it. I think it would be pretty simple to do, but, I mean, I could be wrong on that. So I decided to do Extra Life because I really like the Extra Life thing from the Sonic the Comic. And yeah.
Want some chocolate? Where's that cattle?
I love how he's just like typing randomly. I know he's typing something. Like, I know I deliberately made him type something, but I don't remember what it actually is, though. It's a 10. One up. One up. He has one upped him.
Okay. Maybe if
this is especially where my Eggman impression is very bad.
Yes, that's the one.
Oh, and the light, it's like so bright on the... It doesn't look good at all. But this montage of to my cover of some kind of monster that I recorded, I was going to use the original song, but one, it's off of Saint Anger, which it is terribly produced, and I didn't want to completely make everyone's ears bleed out. Because
yes,
it just sounds
is.
Terrible.
My metal Sonic head! Now I can recreate Extra Life!
And so I decided to make a cover of it. And I also wanted to show my musicianship because on this channel, I don't really show any of my music stuff in particular because the channel is not focused toward music. I think this montage is really good. I think this part where he like paints it to look like it, I think it could have been better. Like maybe it could have faded to that. But other than that, it's actually really good, in my opinion. Like, I like this montage. I'm actually in kind of a dilemma of which one's better between the montage in this one or, episode 7.
Okay, new mission! Extra Life, ship
yourself to Sonic! They're just hanging out. Like, they're not even doing anything. It's probably, they're probably gonna... So, I was gonna have voice lines for Classic Sonic, Extra Life.
Why do you always have to try and be the one to do things? Why can't we just do it?
I mean, Sonic's
Come
the
on.
Main man.
What? No way.
Sonic's the main man here.
You never know what it could be.
But, yeah, I was gonna have voice lines for him provided by, my cousin, which this is his house where I, did the stop motion. It's a different cousin than the Tails voice in episode 6.
Maybe it will help me in my battles against Dr. Eggman.
The editing on like the Extra Life thing and the match is not very good either.
Extra Life.
But I mean, again, this is before I really started editing, which was with episode 11. There's a limited amount of things you can actually do with that figure. Like, you can't even move its legs. You can move its arms and its head, but not the legs. I think I still have it, but I don't actually know. That explosion is just so bad. I need to get a better explosion effect, but I don't really know what a better one would be. So this has like three different locations.
Wait, he's actually up again?
Three different location swaps. This one is at my own house.
I know what this calls
the first
for.
One, and then now.
Okay, if we're gonna beat him, we can't just go separate. We need to have a plan and work together.
So, like this is my house right here. Also, Tails doesn't really talk for episode 8. 9 and... Well, in this episode, because this episode he actually does appear. Because I just didn't want to voice him, because I don't have any voice lines from that cousin who voiced Tails in, Okay, now we're switching back to the cousin's house, where I film... Where I did the... I don't know why I'm saying film, because stop motion isn't filmmaking. I mean, right, technically it is, but
Tails,
it's not really film.
Cut the wire.
Film making! Oh my gosh, I cannot talk.
And Shadow, your
but anyways, yeah, I don't really have any voice lines from her at the moment, but I definitely will try and get them if I can. That Master Hand 321 is very badly edited.
So I'm guessing that that's supposed to be him getting electrocuted because the wire was cut. I should have added, like, lightning effects or something, because, but, like, you know, like I said, this is before I got good with editing videos. The stop motion and combat in this is not too bad, actually, but it's a little bit clunky. Oh, they're all getting around him. They're all getting around him. He's surrounded. That frame, that's like close up on Extra Life's eye. That was literally one of the thumbnail options for the video.
Oh, now I understand why he wasn't being defeated. He was injected with 2 super emeralds.
Which is kind of funny.
Well, I already have.
So this is where they're introduced as super emeralds.
All right, they're going in here.
So yeah. Stop motion Sonic motion episode 10. I would just have overview credits of the voice of every character in the series, so it was a Tails, Anonymous, and, like I said with the previous episodes with credits, I don't understand why I put the voice credits, because they're almost all done by me. So, like, there was 2, voiced by Anonymous, which is the cousin that was Tails and Amy in episode 6. Yeah, Classic Sonic. Yeah, most of these characters aren't even in the episode. Like, Classic Sonic's not there, Silver isn't there, Amy isn't there. Chow isn't there. I don't voice Chow. Chow doesn't even have any voice lines, besides the one scream, which is, I don't even remember where it's from, but it's not from, I didn't do it. This intro is really good. But it's in so low quality because I had to make it lower quality for the episode so KineMaster would actually export it. Which I really hate. Here, instead of using voice clips from the game because it didn't really work, I just used the Sonic Mania voice announce or whatever you want to call it. I think this intro is really good, except for this live-action footage right here. I don't like it that much, honestly, but whatever, I don't care too much. So this is where I actually introduce the silver figure. This is what it's used for. I hate that explosion effect. It's good, but it looks so bad. That scene of, like, Silver and Shadow, like, going up there, like, hands and stuff, that was always meant to be in it. That was, like, pretty much the only thing I planned out that was actually for in it. Is it or is it not use? I really didn't know what to name this episode, so I just named it, is it or is it not use? Because, I mean, it's obviously, I got a reference, it's no use. Pretty much every episode where Silver appears in,
I have to go back and save it's my no future. Use.
So in this episode, hey, so Taylor, I use mouths, like right here. It looks terrible. Really well. So I'm not gonna use mouths
I'm also working on some other
anymore
adventures.
Because I don't know how to really make it look good. Because like there's a lot of stop motion series that are
Silver.
Like,
hey. Come on,
they use professional video editors.
I'm sorry, but
they have, like,
I have to go.
Of, like, things
what
with
do you
them,
mean you
like,
have to go?
Mouths that are like motion tracked, and
well,
then like.
You see, I have this routine I like to do in the morning where I predict
but
my future.
I am
because, well,
no expert in that, and
basically,
so
I predicted my future,
I
and it's being
really
destroyed
don't
by this threat.
Know how to do it
and
very well.
I need.
Because
to
I
make a portal, so I can go back to my
so I can't really make blinks or good looking
like,
mouth stuff.
The world is
that's just a crumb keyed like cartoon
I
mouth
just
thing.
I just
want to
save it.
Which what, is an asset.
I thought Iblis was
from somewhere. I don't quite remember where, but you can see it doesn't look good.
I don't have time to really explain it.
It doesn't really sync up with the audio that well, though.
I just don't have time. I have to go, like, now. All right. Okay, Shadow. You got one of the Chaos Emeralds?
Also, side note, I really hate
Silver's
voice in this. Like, I try to make it sound like kind of like how he sounds in Sonic 06, where he sounds like Sonic, but really stupid.
One. Chaos.
I really should have added keyframes here, just to make it look good. This chaos control effect is actually really good. I think I'm gonna use it in the series from now on. So it fades to black and then fades back in. I was originally just gonna have it be like continuous, but I didn't really know like how to do it. I didn't want to separate it into two parts, so I just decided to do that. I'm not really sure why.
Is this what the future is?
So, for Silver's future world, which I don't really want to put in him being from the future, but I just kind of didn't really know what else to put in here. So, this is supposed to be kind of like the Nether from Minecraft. I know that's kind of stupid, but I mean.
Oh, wait.
I think it makes more sense if you think about it that way.
What kind of
it's supposed to be. And this, he was supposed to find, like, a
strike
like, in a riot happening.
I wonder
if it will strike here. Places and stuff. Or, like, other stuff happening. So he found some match and then he uses it. That's why the explosion happened out of nowhere. When Sonic's like, now it's time for my finishing
and
move.
And even more TNT.
Because that's supposed to be him, blowing up.
You're the destruction of my world!
What's left of
I'll just have to fight you head on!
Fun fact, this, like, this robot... thing. This is what I actually used for the stop motion shots of the invention that Eggman built.
You can try and destroy my world, but it's no use!
The reason why...
Take this! How about
because
this?
I don't actually have that Max E monster. My friend does have it, but, you know. He probably uses it, I don't know. But I just used it for the live action shots. Eggman in here was voiced by a good friend.
I'm not gonna take your word for that, since a lot of your inventions do not do that. In fact, they do the exact opposite.
So that's why the explosion happens. I just wanted.
I just wanted the server appearing to be unexpected. Alright, Robonic, we'll see about that.
So I used both. Oh, this is the new spin dash animation. It looks really good. There's the thing. I just avoided showing the yellow parts. You can see the yellow part right there. That one attacks his foot. That is
left of your invention. I thought you said it would tear me to shreds.
Super Sonic Sync, where he attacks his foot.
Now time for my finishing move. What do you mean?
A lot of these Eggman voice lines are actually not from.
What was that?
These are from this like terrible Sonic Adventure 2 fan dub that he tried to do. And he did Eggman and Shadow, and it was really good. I love how I put Bad to the Bone in here. I wanted to put either I'm Broken by Pantera, which is actually used for the fight, or Bad to the Bone. And I want to use both songs. He said it should have been Bad to the Bone, but I decided to use it. But I also wanted to use I'm Broken.
I was
so
fighting this robot.
I used that for that.
But I finished it, so praise is averted.
Now his voice here just sounds terrible. Listen. The voice line just ended. So this credit style is way better, the font is better, and it's not handwritten out, and it doesn't look goofy. What I was going to say, that what tapping was inspired by the Sonic 2 Super Sonic scene, to the point where I even used the sound effect, right there, it says Sonic 2 for the sound effects, I actually used that sound. From this, it's a scene, but without music. I legit use that sound, the sound from the movie, for that part. Yeah. I really needed things to cram in this so it could actually go to along with the go along with the song so it could actually finish when it was done.
I really like the Sonic 06 soundtrack. It's really good. So it's like the game's not that good, but the soundtrack is amazing. All right. So that is it for the mainline episodes. Now we're getting into the like shorts. This is probably what I'm gonna do once I finish the actual series. Once I'm done with it, I'm gonna upload like shorts, kind of like this. So funny story about this. Turbo Donkey Productions. Those are my first comment on, like, my first, the first comment I really experienced from a channel that wasn't, like, mine or, like, my friends. So I was like, no, I want to feature him in the next one, and he actually, you know, he said he got a shout-out, so, yeah. John Cena just pops out and does bling chilling. And then
God, I hate
continuation.
I know what this calls for.
Alright, right here I use a cover of Live and Learn I made. I should have just used the original song. The cover sounds so bad. This is one I really did not. Like, I could not sing. Well, I mean, I could sing, for songs like this.
You know what? Never mind.
Especially in the high note, like right here.
Well, I'm gonna be abandoning my Ferrari.
Really cool. That's just, it sounds terrible.
I don't need it. I can already run faster than I can drive.
And I can sing really good now.
A comment? What do you mean? A user by the name of Turbo Donkey.
There's the shout out.
Mentioned this on a comment.
Actually, shout out can run fast. He doesn't need a Ferrari. Yeah, he's got his rocket shoes. I agree with you, Turbo Donkey Productions. And if you're watching this, okay. Funny story about this. This video is blocked in certain regions just because I used this one clip of the John Cena entrance. I'm not even joking. The video was blocked in multiple territories, specifically because I used it. And this kind of stuff has happened before. Like, I've got videos blocked from my YouTube because I used like videos that are copywritten. I'm trying to upload a new Sonic movie with Pink Floyd stuff, but I can't do it because it's getting copyright claimed. Not for the songs, but for the Sonic 2 scenes, and I don't have a way to mitigate that, so whatever.
Who are you?
So, speaking of Sonic Movie Mayhem.
One too many chili dogs.
I love how he just explodes. He explodes from the chili dogs. This one So, I don't know if I'm going to continue the Movie Mayhem, honestly. Because I don't have the Movie Sonic figure. And plus, he just goes back to there, so... Alright, there is stop motion Sonic motion so far. I'll see you in episode 12. Goodbye.